I'd now like to introduce Stuart Wheeler.
Well, good morning, conference. Yes, it's me again. And yes, I'm after your money again. And first of all, I'm going to tell you why I'm after your money, and then how I hope to get it. Now, the reason why actually was very well illustrated by Marta's theme, no money, no power. And, or as the Americans like to put it, there's only three things which are important in trying to win an election: money, money, and money. And that's not all that much of an exaggeration. We are a very good party, a wonderful party. And you may know, I didn't see it, but I'm told, and it's wonderful news, that the Daily Mirror has a poll this morning which shows us on 12%. With the Lib Dems on 10%. And whenever you see a poll which you regard possibly as slightly disappointing, remember this. A few months ago we had the London and outside London elections, and outside London, whenever we stood, on average we got 13.8%, while the polls that very morning showed us on 8%. So just remember that. But as well as being a great party, we are a very poor party. We are living almost hand to mouth. And we need the money for all kinds of things. In November, there are probably going to be four by-elections, possibly five, and there are going to be 41 police commissioner elections. Now, for each by-election, if we had it, we would spend £50,000. And we'd spend money, of course, on the police commissioner elections as well. We don't have it. And we need it quite apart from that. We need it for polling, for focus groups, for advertising, for leaflets, for everything you could possibly imagine. So it's quite clear why we need money. Now, when Hugh Williams, who's the deputy treasurer, i.e. he does all the work, and I formed a team 18 months ago, we had a plan as to how we should try to get more money for the party. And we recommended to the NEC that they should increase subscriptions. And we were terrified that we would lose a lot of members, or that at any rate those members who were kind enough to send us a donation with their subscription would stop doing so. Not at all. I'm pleased to tell you that in August this year, we passed the whole amount of subscription money which we got last year. So it is working, you've not deserted us. Please continue to send us donations with your subscriptions if you can possibly afford it, and if you already do so, consider whether you might make it slightly larger. Now, another thing we came up with, or rather it was suggested to us by Mark Harlan, who's going to follow me in just a moment, was a thing called the sovereign draw, which is extremely exciting, but he's going to tell you about that. Then, I'm on to my old theme, wills. It would be very helpful indeed if everyone would leave us something in their will. I have done so, so have most and possibly all of the National Executive Committee. Now, you probably know that it's a very good thing to be a kidney donor, to carry a card in case there's an accident. We all, any of us who do that, hope it won't happen to us. But in the case of the will, we know it's going to happen to us. We don't know when, but it's going to happen. And last year I told conference that I was 76. And guess what? This year I'm 77. But the fact is that we can all die at any time. Almost all of us know some tragic thing where a young person has been killed in an accident or something like that. So please do make a will if you haven't already. And if you have, and you have not left us money, it's very simple to add a codicil. And if anyone wants to know how to do that, you know how to get hold of Letchworth House right there, and we will tell you how to make a will at a discount and how to make, oh there we are, or to write to me there, and I'll tell you exactly what to do, or how to do it. Now, this can be great. We've got, thank goodness we've got it, We've got £90,000 coming to us any moment from a lady who died 4 years ago. Why it's taken the solicitors so long, I don't know, but that's fantastic. And another lady who is here, or Gerouette was yesterday, but I won't embarrass her by telling you who it is, has told me that she's leaving a third of all her estate to you. Most of us can't do something like that. Well, we have our obligations to friends and relations and so forth. But even if you can only leave £50 or £100, please do it. You are going to die sometime, and you don't know when, and it will help this great cause for which we're all fighting. Now, the only other thing I want to mention is the Patrons Club. For £1,000 a year as a minimum, if you're willing to do that, pay us that, we will make you a member of our Patrons Club. You'll get invited to all kinds of interesting events with very good speakers and other advantages too. But one way or another, I hope I've convinced you that we need the money. Please, please, try to help us a little. You can even write a donation tomorrow when you, or tonight when you get home, and send it to Lexcombe House. It really will be put to good use. Remember these four by-elections, if nothing else. Thank you.